I thought I was a Sherlock Holmes fan and knew a bit about it. I know nothing. Compared to these people, I mean, their knowledge, their expertise is quite extraordinary. And they meet up on an annual basis to sort of celebrate Sherlock Holmes.
A lot of Sherlockians read the canon every year, or at least parts of it. They try to keep up.
Well, there's so much detail in the canon, and when we have these gatherings, people are always somehow, there's quizzes, there's questions, and everyone's trying to outdo each other.
I would like now to put you all in reading mode and listening mode, because I'd like to tell you the story, the real story, in the words of John Watson himself, of the giant rat of Sumatra.
I think if Conan Doyle were alive today, he'd be bewildered by what we do. I don't think that authors expect to be remembered 150 years after they were born. Most authors are lucky to be remembered 50 years. Conan Doyle is still with us.
Basically, Sherlock Holmes is the ultimate superhero in the sense that he's so very self-contained. He's always right.
He is eccentric. He's odd. But he's always rational. He understands the law, but more important, perhaps, he understands justice.
It appealed to the Victorians at the time and to modern audiences now.
I think one of the reasons why Holmes remains a popular character for the big screen and the small screen now, too, is that every generation seems to be able to find something in that character.
Before Rathbone and Bruce came onto the scene as Holmes and Watson, Watson was always way down the cast list. He was never seen as a partner to Holmes in the way we now think of him. And it was Hollywood who saw that really there were a partnership.
Done a magnificent job at obliterating it.
Christopher Morley, who founded the Baker Street Irregulars, edited a selection of the original stories, and he called it Holmes and Watson, a textbook of friendship. And that friendship is very important to the stories.
They are great reading. There's no effort getting into them. Watson is the greatest narrator, just about, in the world, because he doesn't expect anything of a reader, and he writes in beautiful prose. Oh, I think Conan Doyle, like most writers, wanted to have interesting characters and people that you wouldn't expect what they were going to do next. And so he was trying to find that mixture between true suspense and entertainment, which I think he kind of succeeded in better than almost anybody else.